Hi, I'm Helen. I'm the Commissioner for Children and Young People in South Australia. I have a challenge for you to design a toy or a gadget for someone your age to take to space. To help you in your designing of that toy or gadget, we're going to use a design thinking process. And design thinking means that you really do need to get to understand and care about the child or person that you're making this for, but also you need to have a little bit of an understanding about Mars. The tricky thing is that nobody's been to Mars, but I do happen to know someone who has been to outer space. She's travelled more than 16 million space miles and spent more than 38 days in space. So let's now hear from former NASA astronaut Pamela Melroy.
Floating around inside a spacecraft with a sensation of no gravity was just about the coolest thing I've ever done. And a crew on their way to Mars would feel the same thing. Now on the surface of Mars, though, there is gravity, but it's only about 38% of the gravity here on Earth. What that means is, if you bounce a ball, it's gonna go really high. You might not even be able to catch it. Mars is pretty cold, and humans can't breathe Martian air. So that means every time you go outside, you have to wear a spacesuit. So if you're designing a toy to play with outside, it has to be really easy to grab, even if you're wearing big, heavy gloves. One challenge in space is that there's not a lot of room. On the space shuttle, we had one area that was our bedroom, our kitchen, and our living room all in one. So remember, if you're designing a toy for space, it has to be okay in small spaces. One challenge in space is that there's not enough room to bring any pets with you. But on the space station, we use robots, including a floating sphere with a camera, and even a robot that looks a little bit like a human to help us out. On Mars, you'll have the same kind of robots and even little rovers. Maybe you can make a pet out of one of the robots that's there to help you. Because it's a special job, you can't take your family with you when you go to space. Making a phone call will be very difficult from Mars because the distance between the Earth and Mars means you might wait 30 minutes before you got an answer to your question. So the best way to communicate will be by sending videos back and forth. Anything that reminds you of home and your family is really special in space. Because you're away from your family for a long time and you're working hard, it's always fun to take a break and play. One of my favorite things to do was to see if I could shoot a Smartie into my friend's mouth from 2 meters away, or see how many somersaults I could do in a row in microgravity. The other thing I loved to do was take pictures of the Earth. Maybe you can help design a toy that will help people on Mars take pictures of the beautiful and surprising environment on Mars to share with their family back on Earth. Design thinking is really important in space because it's not like there's a store right around the corner where you can replace or repair the things that you brought. So you really need to think it through before you take it to space.